हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू द न्यू क्लास ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट एमएम। टुडे वी हैव गॉट अ न्यू टॉपिक बाय द नेम ऑफ ब्रांड एंड ब्रांड इक्विटी। सो व्हाट इज मेड बाय ब्रांड? यू आर यूजिंग दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी एवरीवेयर। दिस प्रोडक्ट इज अ ब्रांड, आई एम यूजिंग दिस ब्रांड, डेट वॉज अ ब्रांड, डेट वॉज अ दैट इज अ गुड ब्रांड। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ब्रांड, हाउ वी आर डिफाइनिंग इट? According to American Marketing Association, brand is the name, symbol, design or combination of them to identify a product to customers and differentiate it from its competitors. Brand can be anything that makes it differentiated from competitors, and it explains the product to the customer. That is called brand. It can be name, it can be logo, it can be sign, it can be color combination, or we can say it can be the overall combination of all these things, sign, logo, name, etc. But the major function of brand is to differentiate one product from its competitor product. That is called brand. Now, you see different advertisements, marketing strategies, different marketing campaigns. The basic purpose lies behind it to make a product is a brand, to make it familiar in the society because of its certain distinguished characteristics. And these distinguished characteristics which makes a product is a brand are called, combinedly we are calling them is brand. Because of these extra characteristics, product becomes distinguished, product becomes very much popular. It is called a brand. Or we can say that brand means a popular product, a famous product, because of some of its extra characteristics is compared to its competitor is called brand. Obviously, you see different brands, you are using different brands, from your mobile phone to your shoes to your cloth to your watch. Why it is a brand? Because it is having some extra characteristics from the other competitor's product. That's why it is called a brand. So brand means the popularity of a product because of some distinguished characteristics, because of its some unique characteristics is called a brand. Simply, they have got, American Marketing Association has got a very simple definition for it, that it may be a name, that it may be a symbol, it may be an outstanding design, or it may be the combination of name, symbol, design, logo, etc. To make the product identifiable, to make the product identifiable and clear to the customer, and to make it differentiated from the competitor is called a brand. You are using this terminology in your day-to-day life. Every person is using this terminology. So now, what's next? Brand equity. What is meant by brand equity? It is the added value endowed to product and services with consumers. Brand equity means customers are thinking, from customers' perspective, they are thinking that this product is having some extra characteristics, extra features. So from customer perspective, what they are thinking that this product is endowed with these extra features, that is called brand equity. Or the distinguished or extra characteristics of a product from the customer point of view is called brand equity. Or we can say it may be reflected in the way consumers think, feel and act with respect to the brand. What consumers are thinking positively, what they are feeling positively and acting positively about your brand, that is called your brand equity. Now you got the point? So now it is your job being a marketer to create strong brand equity for your product, to show the customer, to bring awareness in the society about your product or service, that my product is having these extra characteristics, these extra capabilities, these extra features. So then one day you will be able to create strong brand equity for your product. In this regard, there is a model with respect to the brand equity. Keller's, the name of that model is Keller's brand equity. Keller's brand equity model, it means that this model was made or coined by Keller. So you see, this model is having 1, 2, 3, 4 different stages, and it is shown in a pyramid. Pyramid structure presenting the brand equity model. So number one level, level number one, it shows salience. Salience means identity or awareness. So Keller says that if you want to create brand equity, first you need to bring awareness in the society regarding the name of your product, logo of your product, color combination, package, characteristics, all these things you must need to make your customers aware about all these things, to bring awareness in the society. That is the first stage or first step of building brand equity or Keller's brand equity model. Then you see, we are moving to the second stage, performance and imagery. Performance meaning, performance, how the product performs, what are its characteristics, what needs and wants of the customers will be satisfied by your this product. This is called performance. You must reflect all these things to the society. And imagery. Imagery means how well your product satisfy the customer needs. That is called imagery. Then when you have done with these two stages or performance and imagery, it means that you are giving meaning to your product. How customers will translate your product in their own words or in their own terminologies. Next, when you have done with these two stages, then the turn reaches to the customer. Judgment and feeling, or we can say a response. In this stage, a response will come out from the customer perspective, from the customer side. They will judge the product. They will judge the product on the basis of quality, durability, reliability, price, etc. And how they are feeling about the product, about the price of the product, about the performance of the product, about the quality of the product, durability of the product, reliability of the product, all these things, what they are feeling, whether they are feeling positive or negative, accordingly they will be taking next step. Then the final and the most successful stage will arise. You will reach the final stage. Resonance, attachment of your product with the customers, or we can say brand association, a relationship of the product with the customer. If you have reached to this resonance stage of the brand equity, then this resonance means four things: behavioral loyalty, attitudinal attachment, sense of community, active engagement. It means that this is the most successful stage. You have created brand equity successfully. So what does it mean? Behavioral loyalty. Behavioral loyalty means that they will be repeatedly purchasing your product. They will become your loyal customers. It is called behavioral loyalty. Then next is attitudinal attachment. Attitudinal attachment means that they will love your product. They will not only purchase your product, but they will also create words of mouth in the society. WOM. When words of mouth is reaching to the excessive stage, then there will be buzz marketing. BUZZ. Buzz marketing. Means that continuously these people will be talking positively regarding your product. They will be recommending your product to their peers, to their family members, to their reference groups, to their friends, and to their colleagues. That is called attitudinal attachment, love attachment, emotional attachment is there. Then comes sense of community. Sense of community means that they will connect this product to the community. That this community people are using this product. They will give value to your product. For example, one group of people will be saying that this is the product of elite class people, sense of community. Then it comes active engagement. Active engagement means that probably he is not using your product currently, but he is actively engaged with your product. He is checking prices of your product. He is visiting your social media pages. He is collecting information. He is passing this information to other people. He is asking about new versions of the product. So this is called active engagement. And this is how we are creating brand equity. This model is called Keller's brand equity model because it was represented by Keller's. So brand equity is very much important for a successful brand. And you have studied in product life cycle, PLC, product life cycle, introductory stage, growth stage, maturity stage, decline stage. So why you are spending large amount of money to create brand equity? Because you want your product to run here on the growth stage, not to reach to the maturity stage and not to the decline stage. That's why companies are spending millions and billions of dollars to create strong brand equity. I told you what is the meaning of brand equity. Brand equity means what positive things are there in the minds of customers related to your product. That is called brand equity. From customer perspective, what customer thinks positively about your brand, that is called brand equity. So that's why we are spending large amount of money on brand positioning. The first stage of brand equity, brand positioning, to create, because of competition, there is no space in the minds of the customers for a new product. So we are doing advertisement, we are doing publicity, we are spending large amount of money to create a little bit space in the minds of the customer, to enter your product into the mind of the customer. When it has taken some space in the mind of the customer, in the brain of the customer, then you are struggling very hard to create brand equity so that the customer translate the product very positively. This translation of customer minds of your product positively, it means that you have created brand equity. Thank you very much, students. Be with me for coming classes. Khuda Hafiz.